Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Stassi. Thank you so much for being here today. Oh my god, I'm so fucking excited. This is the biggest roundtable in Stassi history for this podcast, and I'm so excited to be sharing this roundtable with so many amazing royal storytellers. So thank you, thank you, thank you guys for coming here today.
Thanks for having us.
Oh my god, the pleasure is all mine. We're gonna do a quick round of introductions before we start, and I cannot start with introductions without introducing my two fucking fabulous co-hosts. Thank you, Sims Kingdom and Sims Royalty 22, for coming back today.
Yeah, thank you for having us. It's so exciting as always.
I'm excited for you guys to come sit in my chairs and you guys get to ask the questions, no pressure. But I'm so excited. Before we introduce everybody else, I'd like to take a quick minute and introduce my two co-hosts. So, Sims Kingdom, why don't you tell us a little about yourself?
Hi, I am Theoni, aka Sims Kingdoms. I create Sims Royal Stories, starting with the townies that are now royalty, and I stream on Twitch too if you want to come. I have some other challenges, and I'm so excited to be here.
I am excited to have you here. Miss Gabby needs no introduction, as you were last week's podcast, this week's podcast, and next week's podcast. Gabby, welcome back. Oh, no, this sounds a little quiet.
Oh shoot.
No, you're good. You're good. Gabby, quick round of introductions.
My name is Gabby. I run the Sims Royalty 22 Instagram page. I'm a little bit on Twitch, not really, because I switched to working overnight. I have eight kingdoms at the moment, but according to Stassi, I have to add a ninth, so we'll see where I'm at when this comes out.
I'm expecting that
And
Ninth Kingdom, by the way.
yes, no, I gave too much away and now I want to do it, so
Well, Gabby, thank you so much for being here today. Michaela Royal Sims, how are you?
good, how are you?
I am good. Welcome for thank you for being here today. Why don't you tell us a little bit about yourself?
Thank you for having me. So I am Michaela's Royal Sims, aka Michaela, and I am on Instagram, same handle, and Twitch. Right now, my streaming schedule is a little sporadic because I'm getting ready for finals, but hopefully over the summer I'll be a little more concise. I have two main stories going on right now with the Royal Family of Oasis Springs, and I also play the Ultimate Decades Challenge written by Mormid Gamer, but with a royal family, the Royal House of Anora, which is currently in Henford-on-Bagley.
I'm so fucking stoked. I cannot wait to hear more about your Sims Royalty story. Royal of Hearts, welcome back. I feel like we just spoke like 18 hours ago.
Thanks for having me. Hi
Oh.
everyone, I'm Megan, aka Royals of Heart over on Instagram, and I hope to be starting to stream on Twitch very soon.
I am excited for that. Thank you for being here today. Okay, we have. I'm going to try really hard to get this right. Royals of Sims Anastasia?
Anastasia, but hi, it's okay, don't worry, I know it's confusing. Hi everyone, my name's Alice, aka Royals of Sims Anastasia. That's my Instagram handle and also Tumblr. I have a royal story. I've been making it for like a year and a half now. I love it and I'm obsessed with it. And I also stream on Twitch and I have a YouTube series. I recently switched my Instagram with my YouTube. So yes, and that is Alice's Sims, if you wanted to check that out.
That's awesome. Thank you for coming. Mother, oh my, Beth. We're gonna go with Beth.
We'll go
Which
with
is
Beth. It's
we'll go with
fine.
Beth, but it's so sad because like you were the first royal story I ever saw.
Oh, really? Oh,
Yes,
wow.
I know exactly who you are. Iconic red hair. Thank you for coming here today.
Yeah. It's the
What?
red. It carries through in all my genetics on Sims and everything. It's the prominent. That and the freckles.
Yes.
Oh. Oh.
Why don't you tell us a quick little introduction about yourself?
Hi everybody, I'm Beth, mother of Royal Sims. I'm just on Instagram. I haven't really considered any other accounts, I just kind of reached out and got an Instagram one time because I was just shocked that there was this huge community, that you could write stories, just kind of hang out, meet new people, that sort of thing. I have, I think, nine kingdoms. I don't know. There's like 222 Sims in my save. They're all royal. They start Adam and Eve style. So they are some sort of related in some way. There's a couple of them that I've thrown in on quick board nights when I've made my Sulani kingdom. And I'm like, oh, they're too cute. I got to put them in, you know, that sort of thing. You know, I go off, I play other stuff too, but my Royals, I've been playing for about 3 to 4 years in this current save. And, you know, I really just stick with that now too. I do a lot of building, do some casts every now and then. So.
Well, that's exciting. I cannot wait to hear more about your story. Marco.
Hello, everyone. My name is Marco, also known as Vestronia, and my preferred pronouns are he, him. I primarily focus on depicting the difficult and very complicated lives of the royal family of Vestronia and the drama behind it, honestly.
Well, I cannot wait to learn more about your story. Thank you for being here today. Last, but certainly not least, West, thank you for coming here today.
I'm Wes, Red Royals. I have like 20 teams in the world, but I only play like the 6 main ones. And my main one is the Salvadorada Royal Family, which is Afro-Indigenous family in Latin America. And I mainly focus on the 2 sisters, Princess Isabel, that goes into a quest to find the Book of Life to keep her grandpa, King Santiago, alive. And Princess Elena, that gets married into a European prince and she tries to get used to his new European life, while also trying to keep her roots and also researching about the disappearance of Princess Cordelia, which comes from the in-game lore.
That is awesome. Well, thank you so much for coming here today. Now, my amazing co-host, please take this away.
So I don't want to be like...
Oh!
Yeah. No! Oh. It's okay. It's okay.
I was about to say, I feel like we missed somebody.
Yeah, yeah, you just missed me, but it's okay. I don't mind. I really don't mind. It's fine.
I will make it up to you. I don't know how, but I promise.
It's okay. It's okay. Seriously,
Maria, please.
It's okay.
Please.
So yeah, I'm Maria. I'm the AKA Scholar of the Royal Sims. I'm kind of new on these. I just started last year in August. And I currently just like have 1 royal family and 4 noble families that like complement each other. And yeah, I'm just trying to figure out how this is all done.
Well, thank you for coming here today. Again, I will make it up to you. I don't know how.
That's fine. But that's fine.
It's because her name got sandwiched in between mine and Sim's kingdom. And I think you automatically went.
Yeah,
to
I think
us.
So. Yeah. I think that's the reason. That's okay.
I'm just going to put my tail between my legs and I'm going to go. Been a pleasure, guys. Now, please take it away, my 2 amazing co-hosts.
Well, I have a lot of questions that I'm really excited to ask. I'm sure Gabby too. I think one of the first things I wanted to ask is, how did you guys start? What's your inspirations for starting? How did you end up in the Sims Instagram Royal community? Because, you know, everyone has a different path. So I'm really excited to hear about that. And we go.
Okay, so I can start. I can start since I was like the last one to speak. So on my private account, I was playing the Sims, and my private account, I had seen so many Simstagram stories, and I was like, well, this is really cool, and I really want to do something like this, because I was getting bored with just playing Sims and not sharing my stories, and I had like so many families already, I had like 2 or 3 generations, and I would just delete the save, because I got bored. And I started like, well, this is something cool. I really like history. I really like writing stories. So, and I really like royal things. So let's just try and do something like this. And so I started with just 2 Sims. What did get is my current monarch and his grandmother. And suddenly I have like 65 or something. And well, I think it's growing a little bit. It's getting slow, but it's growing.
Nice.
And I just saw all of you. I started and I saw all of you that is right here in front of me. And I'm currently like, I can't not put up to them. This is like way, this is another level and I'm just down here, but I'm getting there and I'm trying too hard to do more. And so, yeah, thank you for your inspiration to like inspiring me.
Well, just want to put before we continue that I'm sure you're amazing and I'm not one to ask. I'm also being here like 1 year and I started kind of horribly. You couldn't really read my first posts, but you know, we just get better and better and it's really fun. So really happy to have you in the community.
Thank you.
And if you feel young, don't. I don't hit a year until like September.
Yeah.
You're already so amazing.
Thank you.
Mikaela, how did you start?
So during the pandemic times, I found Mira Ray's Royal series and I fell in love with it. It was how I was coping. I watched literally all of season one and all of season two in about a month. And I was just like, wow, I want to try this. And so when I went up to university, I created a royal family just for fun. I kind of started in like a medieval era and then was progressing slowly. And my friend was like, wow, you have such an interesting story. I would love to see more of this. And then I was just scrolling on Instagram and I came upon a Sims account and I was just like, people do this. And so one thing led to another and I created the royal house of Ira because I was bored in one of my classes and I made a Sultana Saira and was just obsessed with her. And I was like, I want to play with her. And she and Sultan Inesh became my first monarchs.
That's so sweet. And thank you so much. I'm not a good host. So Royals of Heart, your turn.
For me, I originally started playing The Sims 3 years ago. Mm-hmm. And I also followed lots of Instagram accounts then. But up until last year, it was around the beginning, the 11th of May, I downloaded The Sims for my computer, and 1 week later, on the 18th, my story began. Though I have gone through multiple stories, with each save I play, each story that I tell, each one gets better and better.
Mm-hmm.
One of my favourite things is hosting collabs. Most of you will know that I've got a collab coming out very soon.
We will get back to collabs.
Yeah, I have. See, we are going to talk about
collabs. We will be coming back to that one.
That's so exciting. Thank you. And let's hear from who's next. It's Alice Simstanasia.
Hello. Royals of Simstanasia. I'm so sorry. When I first started my account, I spelt the name really weirdly and it's just been my Achilles heel the entire time because no one can say it right, only me, and I'm so sorry. Anyway, hello. So I actually started kind of differently to most people, I think, because I watched some Sims YouTubers and one day I saw like this BitLife Royal edition for Sims, and someone used like a new Royal BitLife update for their Sims, and I watched that and I was like, oh my gosh, this is so cool. And then because I'd watched that, Mira Ray series made it to my recommended. Then I binged that Mira Ray the icon, and so I binged that, and then I was like, oh, this seems fun, so I made my own royal family. But I actually started on Tumblr, but then it just wasn't hitting for me. So I switched to Simstagram to start my new royal story, which is my current one. So yes, that's my beginning.
That's so interesting to hear that you start. I don't even know how to use Tumblr. I can't even say it. So it's really interesting to see where everyone came from, you know? And Marco Vestronia.
So my story is My personal story is kind of the same as everyone's, but about 4 years ago, I was inspired by the wonderful Mira Ray as a YouTuber and all-around amazing person to create my first Royal story. And since then, I've been sharing my content on Instagram, following the footsteps of talented creators, such as my dear friends Ben, aka Sympathia Monarchy, and Riley, aka Royalty Trade. They were the first that I encountered on Instagram, and I was like, I need to share my royal story too. And I'm so thankful for that. And that's my personal story.
Yeah, I think for us royal storytellers, I think Mira was the first. I think we all kind of played royals before, possibly I did it privately, but I think Mira was the first one that showed us that you can put it out there. I might be wrong, but that's what I think. And we would do West Royals.
It was basically me. I was already playing with a royal family before I met Mary. I had a vampire queen, and then I noticed that people liked the internet. So when I was playing with the legacy edition of the game, my computer had broken. I decided to create a royal family that would work in the legacy edition. I barely had CC now. So I started posting after that legacy computer broke, and I got a new computer. I got now I'm back and could collabs, etc. But it was like 3 years ago.
So interesting how circumstances push us to do something, huh? It's crazy. And do we have? We did. Maria said. I think we covered Deborah. How did we start it, huh? Oh, Mother of Royal Sims. And I have to say,
we're gonna have to keep the bit going for the rest of the podcast. Yes. Somebody has to get forgot every question.
No way. I love Mother Royal Sims, and just so you know, they're also building me a castle, and I'm so in love with it. They're so talented. So how did you start?
I've been playing Sims probably, I think, like day two that Sims had come out. I remember way back when my husband and I were newly married and we were at the Walmart or something like that. And I remember seeing it on the shelves, but I was like, ooh. And he's like, ooh. And I started reading the back of the box, and, you know, my husband looked at it and he said, so you pretty much just micromanage people, kind of like you do it in real life, right? And I'm like, yeah, kind of. Yeah. So I purchased it, and, you know, I was kind of hooked afterwards. I really love the Sims series. I've played desktop, I play console. You know, when a kit comes out, I'm even like, no, I don't want to buy it, but I'll buy it, you know, just because I want to see it. You know, they've got me hooked. It's like, shut up and take my money, you know, type thing. So it's kind of my TV, you know, it's my binge watch, you know, that sort of thing. So, you know, I started playing in that. My Royal series, it's kind of one of the one themes that I've kind of stuck with. I started it probably around Sims 2. Just kind of making a prince and a princess. I'm from farms in Illinois area. So, you know, you just, you know, the princess and prince and king and queen life is kind of complete opposite from what I see over here. You know, that sort of thing. And, you know, I'm used to mud and pigs and cows and, you know, that sort of thing. So I kind of just stuck with it and just kept running with it. And, you know, I do like to just kind of go in the game and just play and then just kind of explain what happens, you know, in my head, like, oh, they did it because of this, you know, they're being totally shady, you know, that sort of thing. And just kind of go from there. And, you know, and then I remember, I think my account's like 2 years old now. In 2020, you know, during COVID and everything, I was actually a regional manager for my current job. And, you know, I stepped down and call it midlife crisis, I guess. I don't know. But I stepped down and, you know, I kind of had a little bit more free time and everything. And I came across Instagram and I'm like, oh my gosh, there's like a ton of me out there. And I didn't even realize it. You know, I always just thought it was personal play and everything, you know, and I talked to my coworkers, friends and everything. They look at me and they're like, say what? You know, Sims, where's that? You know, that sort of thing. And you know, so I joined Simstagram, and I was hooked after that too. I'm like, oh my gosh, this is so great. There's so many people that I've met that, you know, are supportive, and I can sit there and talk Sims, and, you know, my husband won't roll his eyes at me anymore and everything. But now it's even worse, because now I bring my stuff to my family and I'm like, look at what so-and-so posted, you know, and stuff. So he knows everybody just as well as I know everybody now. And I'm like, oh, look at this, you know. So I get them involved too. So, yeah.
This is so funny, because one of the reasons I started Simstagram, except other personal reasons, was that my husband was kind of at his limit with my kingdoms.
Yeah. Mine are too. Yeah.
Hey, I've got a 17-year-old son. I got on my mom and my sister's nerves.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Exactly.
Mm. I was saying same. I got on my mom and my sister's nerves. And yeah. Then my sister likes listening to the drama, but my mom just kind of nods and goes, okay.
My son is 17, and, you know, and I'll even share stuff with him. He never even realized. He's like, I can't believe you put this much lore into that many characters. And I'm like, yeah, you know, I get bored every once in a while, you know, that sort of thing, you know, and it, you know, just to watch him, because, you know, he likes the game, he has a YouTube channel, and, you know, that sort of thing too. But you know, it's just funny, he'll just roll his eyes every time I go to show him stuff. So yeah.
I think it's important and wonderful for us simmers, especially as storytellers, to have people who are also really excited and love stories and storytelling, because my siblings are like that. They don't want to hear about the power dynamics of, like, the monarchy and, like, the turmoil of my characters. But my friend who I mentioned earlier, she loves that stuff, and she always gets so excited to hear what I've been up to. And she even started a royal family because and I helped set it up for her, and she's been in love with it. And it's so nice to have a friend who is also really excited and, like, really happy to hear these stories, because we can bounce ideas off each other and be like, ooh, I like that, what if we did this, what if we do that. And I love it.
Yeah.
My mom is so funny. Oh, sorry, love.
Oh, no, say.
I was gonna say, my mom is so funny, because she rolls her eyes every time I start telling her, like, and this happened, and I'm posting this and this. And then we share a Sims, a resource page, so that she can download the CC I use. I'm like, ma'am, not your low-key my biggest fan, but you're gonna be a hater in person.
Yeah, it's I feel like the Sims Royals community is really good at supporting each other and building each other up. Since I first joined, people I admired for years with so many followers and stuff were so nice to me, so inclusive, ready to help. So that's one of the things I really, really love about the community. And I'm really happy that, Stassi, you brought us all here. So.
Of course. Did everybody get a chance? I think, Gabby, I think you're the only one that, did you get to tell your humble beginnings?
So I was watching Mira Ray back in the beginning when she only had like 10 episodes out. And so I've been following that whole time. And so I started playing personally Sims World 10. And then I saw the BitLife stuff and I still was like, well, I don't really need to share. But then on my Instagram, I was like, I had like binged Mira's whole page. It hadn't been showing up on my personal Instagram for a while, and I went and found it. And then after that, like, two other pages popped up in my recommended. I was like, oh, other people do this. And I was showing my mom, like, because she sees me watch it on I watch it on YouTube on the TV in the living room. I was like, other people do this, and it's not just me and this one person being weird, like. So she's like, well, why don't you post? And so literally the same day, like, I was like, maybe I should. So I wouldn't punk out. I did. Like, I took screenshots of my game as is. There's no reshade. When I'm posting the backgrounds, if you scroll all the way, please do not. But if you do scroll all the way back to the beginning of my page, the background stories are screenshots of the notes app on my phone. Because I was like, if you don't get this out in the next, like, couple of days, you're not going to do it. And now it's a problem because I use it to avoid doing my homework.
that is a frequent flyer for me as well. Who needs to do college work when you can just enjoy, like, if you've had problems that day, you can just take your anger out on Sims. Yeah. And, like, Bob Pancake, no, Eliza, I don't know how many times I've killed her and revived it just for fun of it.
Or Don if you're feeling spicy.
Yeah. I hate Don.
Don has a lot of issues in your game. I don't know what that's about. Even on the show.
I don't like him in general. Yeah.
Anyway. He's a banana. He's a big banana.
I really want to ask about the collabs, by the way, but Gabby, do you want to ask something before that or even that? Because I really want to ask about the collabs.
I have a question about the collabs too. I was going to say, so I think all of us have done a collab. Has anybody not done a collab?
I'm in the process of my first one.
Okay.
But you guys have attended collabs.
Yes.
So you know.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, no, attending counts. I just mean in general, just been a part of one.
Oh, okay. Yeah, no, I've never hosted. I'm too scared.
You'd be wonderful.
Yeah, I've only done one for a reason.
It's fun. It's fun. Help.
And it's fun, but you have to be very aware of what your computer can handle.
Mm-hmm. I'd say start small, because now I have 95 Sims in each of my events, and
it gets worse every time you say this.
I can't say no. I want everyone to attend, and then everyone needs a picture, and it's not good. Don't be me, but you can start small with like 5 Sims.
I'm gonna have to be your moderator, because the last time we had this conversation it was 70. My question was gonna be just in general, what is everybody's idea around collabs, though we kind of answered that a little bit, but just starting with Michaela, what's your general idea about collabs?
I love them. The first time I was reached out for a collab, I almost cried. I was visiting Niagara Falls and I was like, Mom, someone invited me to a collab. And she was like, what are you talking about? And I'm just like, so I've been doing this and I didn't expect it to go anywhere, but like people really liked my story. And one thing led to another. And I just kept getting invited to more and more things. And like, I started meeting people and I got so excited and happy. And I was just like, I want to do this. So I'm in the process of taking photos for my first collab, which a couple of you are attending, which is going to be a wonderful celebration of the nuptials of my twin princesses. And I'm so excited. My game keeps crashing every time I'm doing things, or like the game just is like, haha, I'm gonna leave because the Sims. But I think I might have figured out what was making the Sims all be like, gotta go. But I just hope it. I hope it fixes itself. But I love
I'm sorry. I know I just asked this question, but I am gonna answer to help you with that. If you use the pose setting on Wicked Whims, it can help them stop just wandering off.
Ooh, I don't use Wicked Whims, but I might
download it. I don't use it for Wicked Whims. I use it specifically for posing because they stop wandering off when you do.
Ooh, okay.
And also on, I think MC Command Center, you have to allow how many Sims can be on the lot.
That's what I did last night. I bumped it up to 60. So hopefully that works, because I was posing my last Sim and then the game said, nope. And I was like,
yeah.
I threw my computer and I was like, that's it. I'm just watching Theoni. Because I was watching Sims Kingdom stream while that was going on.
Okay, Mother of Royal Sims.
Yes. Oh, okay. Same question. sorry, it's early here too. Hosting collabs, I'd like to. I guess my fear is, you know, with story driven and everything, I don't want to tarnish other people's characters. You know, I like to honor them and everything and get a good feel. And I guess I just kind of hide back, like, you know, I don't want to tarnish. And then, you know, then I start thinking about my characters and, you know, the dynamics there. And I'm thinking, oh man, do I really want this character to mess with my characters and actually put them through that in life, because I torture my characters some days, you know. I really take them through the ringer some days, but I would love to do it. I'd be open to it and stuff, but it gets scary thinking of all the organization and the things that go into the background of it and all that. You know, it is fun. You know, I've downloaded other people's Sims and put them into my save file before, and it is fun to just kind of take like candid screenshots and stuff and just kind of watch them interact with each other and, you know, see what they do and everything. But yeah, collabs are kind of a scary thing to me. So I would like to know more about it, you know, like the organization and the steps to it and everything else too.
Yeah. I have to say that Princess Lola is the best guest I've ever had, just so you know. I love her.
Yeah. I really analyze sometimes of which Sims that I'm going to send, because Caro, when I get ready, I got to watch Caro's mood. And I can't remember who it was that I sent. I was getting ready to send Caro to just a couple weeks ago, and I just downloaded him into a separate save. And he said something snappy to Mary when I was getting him ready, and she divorced him right on the spot.
You told me that.
Yeah, and I'm like, oh my gosh, what are you two doing? You know, so here they are, they're divorced, and I'm getting ready to send them off to a collab. You know, and I'm screaming at each other, and I just let them go. I'm like, go, just do it. You know, this is your AU. Go do it. You know, but yeah, it just seeing that. Yeah, Lola, she's very well behaved. She's actually Caro's aunt, so she has seven sisters, and I like to think that they all spoiled Caro, and that's the way he became the way he is, because the sisters are all great, you know. His mother's great, you know, they're all, you know, but he's just that pixel is just crazy.
I just really, really quickly, because you touched, I want to say that I feel like in collabs, it's really important for whoever hosts the collab to be really mindful of other people's Sims, because we are not the creator. So like, I always want to ask, like, if your Sim is going to have more lines in my story, I always send screenshots to ask. Most people do it, I've seen, but I've seen some people don't do it, and you know, it's not our creation. So yeah, we really need to be careful how we portray other Sims in our collabs.
And the coolest thing I've ever seen to like kind of mitigate issues with that is asking if your Sim interacts with somebody else, how would they behave or inspire? Are they kind and gentle and quiet, or are they boisterous and loud and aggressive? Like, how would they respond to things? That was one of the coolest things I saw. Also, just like asking somebody, like, they're going to be a part of this, would they go to this? And I'm like, yeah, they go to anything. They don't care about it. I do. I'm always the one of the ones I'm like, I don't care. Whatever happens in your story, I'm going to either pretend like it didn't happen, or I'm going to add it to mine, because I'm just here for the chaos. But asking is always nice. I'm always the one that's like, I don't care. You can dress them however you want. I don't care. But Royals of Hearts, I know you. I think I've been in a card collab with you a couple before.
Yes, you have. For me, I love doing collabs. It's the way to, you can expand relationships between different accounts, you know, build friendships. It's all about the community coming together, stuff like that. Can I do a single event that I'm doing just for my Sims, but turn it into a collab? Yes. Yes, I can, because that's happened millions of times. I want to do one event. I do that event, but I add more just to make it fun. Like, it creates work for myself, but I'm happy to do it. It's really something I enjoy. And it distracts from storytelling as well, which is, I know what I want for a story, but it's what they're going to say is my problem. So I have a challenge with my current story that I'm playing. I'm deciding to have at least one sim from every account that's taking part would have a line. But I'll be messaging people individually about that.
I love wow. it.
You're braver than me. Everybody was silent on my collab. Alice.
Hello. I've done a lot of collabs. I think within a week of creating my account, I did a collab. So I've kind of been just doing them from the get-go. But I really enjoy them and they're really fun to do, but they can be very stressful. I remember for my coronation collab, I had like 47 accounts attending and I was so, so stressed. I actually did, I know. And I was very, very stressed. And my mods folder went up by like 10 gigabytes and I just, my game was just not okay, but it was fun and it worked out in the end. But yeah, I love doing collabs where I can use my story with it. So I did a 25-year ball collab. And if you've seen my story, you'll know a lot of tea happened there. And it was so fun because I got to incorporate other Sims and like have them like actually say things in like the story post as well. And that was so exciting. But yeah, I think collabs are so much fun to do. And I just have an amazing time doing them. And I also, I don't know, no one's really mentioned this yet, but also marriage collabs between between kingdoms, that's something I'm kind of starting to dip my toes into because I haven't done it yet. So I'm sort of planning to ship off my some of Eleanor and William's kids in the future to other kingdoms because not that I don't have a storyline for them, but I kind of don't, so I'm just gonna let them deal with it instead. So yes.
Well, me and Royals of Heart kind of have a marriage collab coming up, which I'm really excited for. And I also love marriage collabs, so just want to put that there.
I've only done one, but I want to do more. But I nobody wants more Sims because we all have too many.
Hey, I'll take them. I can't say no, guys.
No, I've already told you. I'm now your moderator. I'm not encouraging the insanity.
Since the Nasia did with more accounts than me, so there is a bigger limit.
That, you both have problems. We're not gonna what?
It's not a problem. It's just you want everything.
Yeah.
It is if your laptop is this close to exploding, and we know all of ours.
I mean, I do have a gaming PC now, so it's a lot easier to host bigger collabs. But when I had a laptop, oh my god, it overheated all the time.
Fan, like their computer is a live bomb.
Mm-hmm.
Oh yeah,
mine is. Just screams.
Yes.
Wes, I was a part of a collab with you too, so I know you have some collab feelings.
My first collab was actually with Alice. I'm not going to try to say the name of the collab.
Yes.
I had the first collab with her, and then I decided to make my own collab in February. The last time I went, it was a carnival collab. And I'm also planning my next one for teens and kids. That will be a winter solstice / junior party. It will be around June. Yeah. That's what I think for collabs. I also have some marriage collabs. I have one with the Harper with Megan for talking, and I also have one. I forgot her name, sorry. Michaela.
Oh, Michaela.
In her legacy, history shard, right?
Pardon?
It's the history. Oh.
It's the decades
challenge. Yeah. Yes, some people send me their Sims to marry into my royal family.
But basically that.
Yeah, I love having Alina. She's so sweet, and I'm just like, because she just lost her husband to the Black Death, and I was just like, no.
Yeah, my Sim died there too, but had babies. So
rest in peace.
No, I'm playing the decade challenge. What'd you say?
I sent Emily to Michaela. Oh.
Yes, who is the current queen right now, and
sneak peek, she rolled to die, and I was like, no, no, I refused. They already lost all their daughters. I was not losing the queen.
No, sometimes as the author, you have to make executive decisions.
Yes, exactly. And one of Morbid Gamer's rules on the challenge is have fun. If you don't like a rule, don't follow it. Like, that's my philosophy with all challenges and stuff. If you don't like something about it, do mm-hmm. what you want. No one's gonna be like, how dare you grow green beans in autumn? Like, no one's gonna say that.
Maria, because we don't want to forget you again.
I just recently participated in my first collab, but I never hosted one. I'm just too scared to do that. I think about it like when my king was crowned, it was just him and his grandmother, nobody else. Then I got like him married, and I thought, well, perhaps now I've been doing this for a few months, I can try. But then I'm just like, I'm kind of scared that no one wants to come. I'm kind of scared that I can't do. I'm kind of scared of a lot of things. And so that's why I just recently participated in my first, like, someone asked if we wanted it. I'm saying, well, perhaps now I can try. And so I, oh, look, if you would like, I can go. And so, I'm trying to. Maybe in the near future I will try to do one, but I really love watching like all of your stories mix, like all of your Sims in another story and the Sims from this one in another, and the king or the prince or the duke or like, oh my god, these people are amazing, and I just how I want to do this, but I'm so scared. So yeah, I'm just trying to, but yeah, I love collabs.
For everybody scared, start with one or two.
Yeah.
That way you get the feel of like having other people's Sims in your story or what it's like to have to set that up. That way, if you really want to do it but you're scared, just start with one or two. Now, if you don't want to do it, that's different. Don't do it if you don't mm-hmm. want to do it. But if you want to do it, I say start with one or two. I think I only had like 5 people involved. I wanted to invite everybody because I feel like everybody's my online friend. Like, I just wanted to invite. And I was like, no, you can't. I was like, the first 5 people that pop up, you is the who you have to invite, because you can't go over this because you're gonna be stressed out. And then I was stressed out with the 5 people anyway, so it was so bad.
Yeah. I'm so scared. That's why I think I'm like always creating more Sims so I can have more people in my events, but without having to invite others, because I'm really scared. So I just stick with my own, but I'm like thinking seriously in the near future, like what happens to my story next, like having a mm-hmm. small one, like we'll see.
You have a call full of people who would join if you ask. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and if you need help or tips, I'm not an expert at all. Like Simstanesia does it. When Simstanesia does it, it feels like natural. I'm
always gasping.
Yeah,
always exactly. gasping.
Yeah, when exactly. I do it, it's torture.
I'm like,
what did you say, Marco?
I said that I couldn't agree more.
Yeah.
I'm the absolute best at the collabs.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah.
And Marco, you're up.
Okay, so collaborations are my absolute favorite, especially event collabs like weddings, christening, coronations, and balls. There's nothing like the excitement of dressing up my Sims and anticipating the final outcome to see what other creators created with my Sims. And also very special is being a host for a collab, because mm-hmm. seeing all the Sims dressed up and receiving all the compliments for the final outcome is very amazing. Every detail, no matter how small it is very special to me, including unexpected occurrences like having a Sim giving birth or dying in the middle of the wedding. That's part of the collab.
Yeah.
And my first collab was with Simpathia Ben. He was such an inspiration to me, and being part of his story was so special. And today, my favorite Sim of his has married mine. So that's very special to me. Also, the wedding collapse and the story collapse are at the absolute best. Like having, because I only have one kingdom in my story, having other kingdoms to interact with mine and having their scenes be part of my story and seeing them grow and interact, it is the absolute best. I'm currently part of an alliance collab with my closest friends, including Alice, and their scenes are like mine because I use them without even asking them. Like, I have them in my gallery and just download it and send them the photos when they're ready. And I'm like, yeah, I use them for a baby shower. I hope you don't mind. And yeah, I really like that.
That's really nice. I wanted to ask, that's another thing I want to ask about collabs. How do you guys feel about stories? I know there's some collabs, royal collabs, where it's just the events, nothing happens, and some collabs have stories. I like to include stories in the collab without having them affect my guests, of course, you know? But how do you guys feel about that? Like, not everyone has to answer, it's like just a general opinion.
I think having a bit of both is nice. Like, I've done both myself. In general, I always do a collab if I've got something big going on, like a royal wedding, a coronation, a christening, which I've got coming up soon with baby. And then I've done a couple of story-based ones. Or it's like, I'll do a collab, like for my coronation at the ball. I had story posts, but just with my Sims after. I didn't actually include anyone's Sims for that. But also at the same time, it was so much fun to do the big 25-year ball with like using everyone's Sims as well. So I think they're both really good and it's nice to find a balance between them.
Mm. Yeah, I have a very similar opinion. Again, I'm only working on my first collab and I think it's a little much for me right now to add like story, like what Theoni does and add like everybody gets a line or things like that. It's a little too much for my first one, but I love because people have texted me when they're working on their collabs being like, hey, I want Uma to interact with Lavina and them just to talk for a moment. Is this okay? And I'm like, yes, please. Because in my game, I've noticed that Queen Nancy of Sims Kingdoms is very, she tends to talk with Saira and Inesh quite a bit. So I'm just like, maybe next time I'll have them have a little visit and they'll have like a tea party and they'll just talk because they're both Oasis Springs kingdoms and they're just all so lovely. And I get so honored when people want to interact with my Sims and like they say, hey, I want them to talk to this person or I want them to dance with this person. I'm just like, yes, please. I feel confident in sending my Sims to these creators because you're all so understanding and loving, and I know that you'll respect my Sims and you'll respect that Inesh and Zaire are very much in love and they wouldn't like cheat on each other, and you wouldn't do that, you wouldn't take advantage of that, and if you did, well, I would be very sad, but I know none of you would do that because you're all so lovely.
Aww.
Am I talking too loud? I feel like I'm talking too loud.
No.
Okay.
I was going to say for the overwhelming part, to mitigate that, what I did for mine was I had like just pictures for the most part of events. And then I had like a slide where it was like speech bubbles of like tiny snippets of conversations that could possibly be happening where they weren't like real in depth, but just like, I think like I had Maggie telling a story to, who did you send to me, Sims Kingdom? Malcolm's wife.
Look, I don't say no to collabs. I've sent to 100 people.
I can't think of her name. It's Malcolm's wife.
Sophia?
Sophia. Princess Sophia. Poor Princess Sophia.
I love Sophia so much.
She's so sweet. In my game, she was so sweet.
Oh, yeah, and, like, for the wedding, I remember.
I had her talking to Maggie, and they were, like, telling, like, Maggie was telling, like, childhood stories. Stuff like that. So where it's not like it doesn't affect anybody's stories, it's just them talking.
There's no right or wrong way to do a collab. It's just the fun way to do a collab. I just like torturing myself. That's personal.
Well, Gabby, I like what you said about the slides and everything, because I'll do that of the Sims that, you know, people have put into my game and, you know, things like that. If they're interacting with my Sims and stuff, I'll take like quick screenshots and send it off, and I'm like, guess what? Yeah, you know, look at what happened and everything, and just kind of talk through it. And, it, you know, and I can kind of get the approval and the feel, you know, if I, you know, if the other person doesn't feel comfortable with it, then yeah, I can definitely get that read when I send the screenshot. But I'll send like the actual screenshot of what was going on during that time of like, look at this, you know, look at what happened. Yeah. And that sort of thing. And it's fun. It's a good conversation to have, you know, it's just really fun to show, you know, their Sims versus my Sims and, you know, what they're doing together and everything like that. Cause like right now my Crown Princess of Willow Creek with Starlight Sims, they immediately, like her family of Sims came into my Sulani kingdom when I was building that. And, you know, immediately the two brothers just started following her everywhere, you know, and they just kept fighting over, you know, like they just kept standing in front of it to talk to her and everything. And I just kept sending her all these screenshots of like, oh, Koa, Kakai, yeah, and everything. And then finally it was just Koa, Kakai just backed off and started going other directions with things. But yeah, it was so fun to watch. But I do like what you said about the screenshot.
Anybody else have anything for the question? Because my next question had to do still with collabs on the span collab.
I have something to add.
Oh yeah, go ahead.
Well, I took the next step, I think, in the Sims interaction since one collapsed by actually killing off another creator Sim. Oh. Don't worry, he wanted him dead too. It was at my ball because you should tell them my story. I won't tell you more. But yeah, it was a crazy twist of the story and made the collab, I think, even more epic. And I don't think anyone expected something like this to happen in a ball collab.
Yeah.
Straight
as chaos. Long as there's consent, that's beautiful. It sounds amazing.
No, because now I have ideas.
Oh my god, not sending you my Sims now,
Gabby. No, you
no, not no, I meant sending my Sims somewhere where I know their game has chaos and just letting them die.
Oh, nice.
Royal I'm not Sims just gonna kill games. Anybody's Sims. No, that would make me so sad.
My question Morgan did, but like Inesh is getting older and Sayira is getting older, and I'm like trying to think about how I'm gonna eventually do their funerals, because as you can see, I am a white person, so I've done a lot of research to properly portray Inesh and Sayira. And something I did deliberately when making them, I talked about this on stream before, was that I did not want to play into the stereotype of the wife is like quiet, domestic, does nothing. Sayira is actually quite outspoken, and she's a patron for a lot of organizations, and she works very hard to make the kingdom a better place to live. And I'm in my research, I found that funerals in India, where a lot of my inspiration comes from, is a very joyous time where you're more so celebrating life, but it also still is a sad occurrence. So I'm trying to think about the proper grieving of the family as well as the celebration of their life. So that's something that's going on in my head.
Love that. I just was going to add in the span of collabs, as well as just a little bit, because I know it's the same for a lot of people's storytelling, but in collabs, how do you organize? Because I know some of us use like Google Sheets, and then some of us use a document to add stuff into. What is everybody's preference?
I'm gonna start. Is that okay?
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay. I use both. I normally use a doc to write out everything I want to do and like a guest list and everything. And then I use a sheet for everyone to put all of their information for their Sims on, links, eye colors, because I can't stand getting other people's eye colors because they're default replacements. And it usually gets rid of my own eyes, and that stresses me out. But anyway, and then I have another sheet. So when I'm actually doing my collab, I kind of make sure that I use everyone's Sims who sent me them, because I've seen in some cases where the creator did not mean to at all, but like they've been missed out of an event, and it's happened to me before, but I really don't want to do that, so I always make sure to include everyone's sims, and I kind of like have a checklist, and I normally put people into groups, so like keep the groups the same for each event I do, and I just use it as a checklist. So yes.
Very similar to what I do. I, again, first collab, I took a lot of inspiration actually from Sims Royal Heart, because she was prepping for a collab, and I was like, okay, I think I kind of understand. I'm just going to use this kind, not as a template, but I was just looking at it being like, okay, so you organized it like this. I'm going to do something similar. And I made it look all pretty. And I have it all on one document. Plus on my notes on my phone, I had like some extra stuff that I was planning.
I think I stole my format from Royals of Heart too.
She just does such a great job organizing.
No, it's very so detailed. The events are really specific. Like it I love it, because, and then when we're going back and forth for the last one, because you're like, no dark colors, and I'm like, but their kingdom colors is brown, and I don't want to mess up what you got going on, but I don't know how to fix, like, I was kind of panicking a little bit.
My collabs, if I have a certain vibe going for them with them, if they're that vibe, I try to keep it as close to as I can. Like for my empire, the United Empire of Hearts, for them, their colours are blue. So if it's like a ball, I'd prefer not to have blue scent, but I don't mind it. Or say one of them that's coming up in the multi-state visit is Lily's birthday. The little print. One of the little princesses, Lily, is turning 7. She's getting a title, and I thought I'd do it, make it a part of it. And I've also decided to now add in a coronation as well. God, why do I get these ideas from the event happening all around the world or on different accounts? And that looks like, yeah, that's really fun. I've got to do something with that. Like, I know mine go over the top, like, oh God, they're so wacky, some of the ideas. I swear I've become even more crazier from just the events that I host. Like, what do I get myself into? I try to limit myself to 25 accounts because I know that's what my computer can handle. It also makes things easier. Like at one of the balls, I have a group dance coming up for the children, for the adults as well, as but the children's one is the one I'm most looking forward to. Because like Sims will be randomly paired up and they'll be shown dancing.
That sounds adorable.
Little bubbas.
This is why I asked for kids to be sent. I thought it'd be a good idea to have them to accompany the parents, like what get a taste of what they'll do when they're older. Start taking on more royal duties. And then they end up dancing with someone.
That's adorable. The little babies are always so cute. They just never behave. And it's so hard to find like royal poses for them. They're all the same.
Well, yeah, everything is a struggle.
I'm not gonna lie, from collabs and like how I organize them is I have them in like 4 accounts in one group. So, and in there, I once had autonomy turned on, and I'm not going to say who it was. But it was someone in this podcast, and they ended up having a child with one of my king, with the Emperor of Hearts.
Still the tea.
No, I was gonna say you're gonna have to drop that tea, died. Especially if it's AU.
Who was it?
I'm
gonna guess Michaela because she laughed before she can hear.
I'm guessing Michaela.
Before she could even get the sentence out, Michaela started laughing.
Okay, I'll drop it. It was Malcolm from Sims Kingdom.
Of course it was. No, of course. Has he ever done something correct? Yeah, because has he ever done something correct? No, or why would he, you know? It's fine. It's Malcolm, I expected needs to him.
Get his shit together.
Look, guys, Malcolm, wow. He's 16, okay? Like, he is a baby. He's horrible, but I have hope, okay? Yeah. He's one of my babies, I hope, but he's horrible. Like, anyway.
No, if I was married at 16, I'd probably be horrible too.
Yeah. he's at that age and situation where he can't see that he's not the only person in the world with issues, so he's like, I have issues, leave me alone. It's like Sophia's whole family died. Anyway, I'm sorry. I have a question. I just want Stassi to ask us a question because we're all royals, so I want to see what a person with a non-royal so I really want to hear a question from poor Stassi that we took her podcast over.
It's our podcast now.
You say it's your podcast.
Yeah. I told you I'm stealing it. I told you this like three when I was on like three podcasts ago. I'm slowly stealing it.
Slowly. Well, you're welcome to every podcast. I mean, every podcast needs a co-host. Hey, I'm enjoying being a guest, kind of just watching you guys, and literally like I said in the 100th episode, I enjoy about halfway through every podcast, everybody gets this little glimmer in their eye because they're so excited and they're finally feeling comfortable. And I just watched you all do it. And that's why I fucking do this podcast. I feel like for questions, like you guys are actually having really good questions because you guys communicate every day with each other. You guys collab with one another. My questions were kind of more like surface-based questions of being... which I have talked with Gabby and Kingdom of Hearts, that we know that in The Sims, like there's lots of different expansion packs and that's great, but there's nothing really royalty themed. There's no, like there's, you can't really build a good castle. There's not poses. So God forbid if they throw poses in, there's no really good ball gowns or anything. And we know that there's going to be more expansion packs coming along the way. And my question kind of was, is what would be your dream expansion pack for royal storytelling?
Okay.
And anybody can go first.
I am personally against kits. I really don't like them. I don't like the premise of them. They're a cash grab. And this is just my opinion. Sorry, EA. You have a great game.
We have the same opinion. It's okay.
Okay. Thank you. Yeah. I only recently went to the dark side and bought the Courtyard Oasis kit because I really wanted it and I just needed stuff. But if there were to be a kit, because kits are built to be a niche topic, I would want like a build kit and a cast kit and maybe even a gameplay kit if those ever come back, but specifically for us royalty players, because I doubt that would happen, but it could, like they could collab with some creators like Bess from Westeros makes wonderful tiaras and stuff, and I use so many of them. Sifix makes wonderful ball gowns, and I would love for them to work with content creators to make a royal clothing kit with maybe some like fascinators and things that we all use, and just and like a CAS kit that maybe even is medieval themed, who knows, not CAS kit, build kit that maybe even is medieval themed. I would love it to be its own game, maybe a medieval Sims 4 thing or even like a game pack kind of, but I don't see that very likely. But kits kind of I feel like could be a possibility, so Sims team, hit me up.
Topic here, and anyone noticed that when Sims have when EA has collaborated with things, the game packs, like Journey Batu, that is, honestly, what was the idea behind that?
Yeah.
Money.
Complete money. Crap, waste of money.
Yeah.
The werewolf packs build. James Turner, formerly known as The Sims Supply, built the builds for the werewolf pack. My goodness, they are phenomenal. I love them. I don't play with werewolves very much, but I bought the pack full price because I wanted the build. Because
James Turner is just such a good simmer, like a good builder. Same with Little Simsy, Plumbella, Claire Chavon, all those creator network people that have worked on the builds, they make the pack feel fuller. And mm-hmm. imagine what like our community could do if we were given the resources to build these things, like, and like create these nations. And like I'm passionate about this one.
I personally just think some sort of game mechanic of a monarchy is what I'm just praying for, because the royalty mod and the royal family mod, they're great, but there's certain things where it's like just one overarching monarch and it kind of feels like of the whole Sims world, whereas I know everyone has all these different kingdoms, and like being able to name your Sims like the actual title that they are and having it fit in the name, because that's a real bug of mine. Because I can never have my Sims full name because I want queen or princess in front of it, and it's so annoying. But yeah, I think also just like some new worlds that are just have 64 by 64 lots. That's what I'm praying for, just so I can build more palaces. And
just 64 by 64, I'm like asking for 100 by 100.
I know, the palaces are huge. It's not even, they're not even big enough, that's the thing. Or
no,
just like,
no, I'm like, yeah. Just 64, come on, give me a block here.
Give me a world.
Yeah, or just like some build by items that like come with the game that would be able to properly make palaces look good without using CC. In terms of like actual cast, I don't really think we need many dresses, because you've got the wedding pack, you've got some really nice things that come with the base game, and I think CC kind of does its job. But maybe tiaras would be nice, but
to tell you the truth, CC does do the job, but for people that play without mods, which I can't even fathom personally as a player, but there are people that cannot or do not want to. Mm-hmm. When I was making my royals, there are no long dresses, and I understand modern monarchy and stuff, but I'm an old style gal, okay? I want my Sims to wear these big dresses that I want to wear in real life, okay? So that's what I want them to put in. And one of my questions also was what mods or CC you guys use. I didn't even go in the game because I'm not that optimistic. But like, I don't know, like Marcos and West Royals and Maria, like what do you guys think about like the CC or, you know, inclusivity of
Royals? About the CC and the mods, I started playing The Sims. I play Sims 1, 2, 3, 4, Medieval, all of them. And when I started playing The Sims 4, I had friends who use mods and CCs, and I'm like, nah, I'm not going to use them. Like, no, I like everything that comes with the game. And then I start using them slowly, and now I cannot stop using them.
Yeah,
I think that's the problem. When you have, you need more, and you need more, and you need more. And so when I started doing this story, I was like, I cannot play this story without CC, without mods, without, it's like, it was impossible if I didn't have them. And now I'm always looking for more and always thinking of not like, almost not repeating the same outfits, but at the same time, you don't have much, so you need to repeat them. And you need to think like, for example, in my case that I have so many Sims at the same time, and I dress them and all of that. And I'm like, look, I know I use this dress with the other person, and I need to, I cannot, I don't know, I don't want to use the same on the same event. And so I think we need more referring to the to what we wanted the EA to do. I think that the kit that Michaela said about the CC and about clothing and accessories and such, I think we need more to complement what we already have with the CC. Mm-hmm. I think that would be I think it would be good.
Other Royal Sims, you've been quiet for a bit. Or Wes, you were speaking, go ahead.
As for some, my neighbor is listening to reggaetons. I don't know if you can hear me, but
no.
I don't know if you can hear the music. Answering the first question about the content in the game, I think that for royal stuff, I would probably prefer something West African. Because like I already have the CCs for like European stuff, but like African, you don't have in the game, and you also don't even have like barely CC about it. Like kind of wanted like more packs focusing cultures, because many of these cultures do have royals, and I always want to like add them into my world, but I can't because there's barely nothing. Yeah, like that's this problem.
Yeah.
Yeah. Usual players console who can't even get like the CC and stuff. It's kind of like that.
No, you're definitely right about that one.
Mm-hmm. Can't believe they only recently added hijabs into the game. Like they're so beautiful and there's so many different versions of it. I literally have a CC pack that is just a ton of different style of hijabs, and those were added during the wedding pack era.
They added the hijabs in the game. I didn't even notice because I have the CC ones. I'm like, when?
Well, that shows that there's a problem. There's
like city leaving, and only now they added hijabs.
Yeah, niqabs, they don't have one. No, I downloaded. No. I found three, and I alternate them. I had one, and it clipped with a nose, so all my niqabi sims had no nose because I would like put it in so that the niqabi wouldn't go through the niqab. You know, anyway,
the game is missing a lot of basic things for representation, like certain hairstyles, certain accessories, like certain clothing styles. Like the game is missing that, and I really want it.
Hey, and it comes with, I feel like, I just feel like, especially for niqabis and hijabis now, because that's the one I'm more versed in, you know, I feel like it has to do also with misconceptions about what oppression is for women, because I mean, of course there is oppression there, where everywhere, but also some people want to express themselves, and there is no, they put hijabs, but they haven't put any like traditional hijabi or niqabi clothing where my sims can dress, yes, in that way, modest. Like that type of modest, the dress, like, you know, the religious type or whatever, cultural, they don't have it. I had to download it, and it's so difficult for my niqabi sims to dress and be pretty, like Queen Meredith. Of course she was to dress pretty, but I also, it's, anyway, one of my favorite queens. Anyway, sorry guys.
Yeah, no, I definitely agree, because my hijabi sim, I always feel bad because I feel like she's not covered enough. And I felt bad because I had to be like, this is the most covered I can get her. So like a lot of outfits, I can't take a picture from her from the back because her back is out. Mm-hmm. Or like is short sleeves or stuff like that. And I'm like, I kind of had to just like go with it, which I don't like. I don't like at you all. Can... It makes me very upset. I can't just not mm-hmm. show her. She's the royal vizier to my sultana. So I can't just not show her. But yeah, like, if it's not a big ball gown, and I've only got like five of those, if it's not a big ball gown, that's CC, by the way.
Yeah, of course.
Something is showing that traditionally wouldn't be if you're a hijabi, which is frustrating.
You can download some accessory CCs to be like undershirts and stuff. That's what I did.
I started doing that. Yeah.
Yeah. And long hijabs to cover the cleavage, because, you know, anyway, that's what I did.
One thing that I wanted to add about representation in the game. I remember there's a account on Twitter that actually talks about Jewish representation in the game. And she's been like, I think 400 days asking the game to add Jewish culture into it. I don't remember the name right now. I think that's Pompom, something like that.
Yeah, the gallery is very anti-Semitic, which was very surprising. Yeah, really.
Oh my gosh.
Not even again, like Vladislav Strat is basically like an anti-Semitic stereotype. Darren Charm is also like,
yeah.
Just needs to do better. Like all the stuff that we're talking about, it needs to be base game, and I will rage if it's not base game. And I'm really glad that Paralives and that other new one is coming out, because it's giving the Sims competition. Mm-hmm. So now they're going to have to add these things to keep their player base, or else we're all going to move to another platform.
Yeah. I mean, not really for me, but yes, tell them.
Don't tell them.
Yes, that. I'm leaving. Probably not.
No, it's so hard because it's something you're genuinely in love. Like, it's a huge part of all of our lives. You don't want to just like leave it on the table, but like, especially because you've invested so much time and so much money. Like, I've been playing The Sims since I was like 8. I'm 22. That is a significant portion of my lifespan. I'm not old or anything, but like, that's a lot of my life just in reality. And there are days where I'm just like, this is a disgusting thing that the community is beautiful, but the company is terrible. And then like, I felt like I was experiencing it all over again because I just started playing D&D. And then they went off the rails and I'm like, I can't escape it anywhere. Like, can big companies get it together?
Yeah.
Well, in POC talk, but I really hate kids about turtles. Like, I really just like to wait, like, just one thing, like, it's the architecture of the culture, I think nothing for me. Like, it's the clothing of a specific part of the culture and nothing for me. Like, I really hate it.
Yeah.
I
got scared when they were announcing Tartossa because someone said, what if it's Greek? I'm like, please, I cannot take another. Look, I'm sorry. I know it's a fun thing, but when I first saw in Sims 2 toga parties, I was kind of triggered. But it's okay. It's fine. I understand. It's a lot of fun. I would do the same. But it was, I was like, please, Sims, don't, it's fine. Just don't do my culture, the sister creators. Culture? Yeah. Yeah. Well, actually.
Which is already gross and shouldn't be emulated. Like,
it was Sims all that. We didn't have anything back then, you know, like, anyway. But yeah. I was happy they didn't do my culture, so I can only sympathize with people that I don't know, you know. I love CC and mods, so I'm like, just leave me with them. But then they should get paid, really, like, realistically, they should get paid. It's interesting. It's, but then if you, some of them, if you work with EA, then they take away aspects of their mods or CC that are deemed as non-family friendly, that I actually need for my gameplay. And I'm not talking about specifically, like, for example, Wicked Whims, okay? Because I understand a little more family friendly and then whatever anyone wants, you know, like, I don't want monster things, but even simpler things, even like, I'm like, I don't want to know what's going to happen to the LGBTQ plus mod if they start working with EA, but I want them to get money, you know? Anyway, it's interesting. It's interesting.
I have a quick question and I want to go rapid fire. I don't want anybody to think too hard about it. And I want to go in the order that's in the chat from earlier. So you don't have time to think about it. Top three CC creators, my brain blank. Because I want to know Stassi's too. You got to go first and then we'll go with the order in the chat.
I go first for CC, Enrique Hair, Sims Trouble. And I don't know the dresses I use, but them. I'll take a third one. I'll do the one that does Deco Sims. They fucking saved my life a million times and a half over. I hope that was good. Rapid fire.
Michaela,
you're okay.
Sifix, A Harris 00 Brittany, and for medieval stuff, definitely Sims Carpenter, I think, or I can't remember the full name, but they make wonderful CC conversions from the Sims Medieval. They make just great things. They made the headscarf base game from Growing Together. So yeah.
Royals of Sims.
Quick question. Is it a certain thing or can it be all three of, like, can it be cast, build, and
nope, anything, stuff. Whatever your top three CC creator is.
Simsuani, Felixandra, and the Devilers.
That's the Devil Sims, I think.
Those are good. Mother of Royal Sims.
I definitely say Felix. The heavens gave me Felix to save my interest in the game. Sims Trouble. I love Sims Trouble here, mainly because it's like hot mess, you know, type style. I can kind of get that going a little bit with it. And then definitely Civix. I love the ball gowns with Civix.
Let me some Civix.
Yeah.
Alice.
Rimmings and Rusty for clothing, and also Rusty for hair. And also the Marble Mortal for build by, because they really have just furnished all my palaces for me.
Marco.
I have to say Regalia for dresses. Sims Trouble for hair is a very good choice. And the Devilliers for poses are the absolute best because, yes, they make such special poses.
Wes. You're on mute, babe. You're still on mute, babe.
You're muted. You're muted.
Can our?
Oh, there we go.
I forgot. I was talking about Rusty, which is a sea creator to make dresses, and also I like the emotional poses from Sun Seasoning is the name, and also see if people make a lot of albums, but this is them.
Maria.
So the Devilier, of course. So I don't know. I don't really know how to say. Melon Sloth, and I think Raining. I think I use also Raining Sims. I think like these are the first three that come to my mind. I have like a lot and separated into folders, and I don't really know. Sometimes I don't really know which one I'm using, and it's a little bit bad. But I use a lot. These are the first three that come to my mind.
And Sims Kingdom.
Well, Lumpina for the LGBTQ plus mod, I cannot play without it. From people we haven't said, Katharos Royals makes really nice poses and Haraki Sims. And my third one, because I said four, but my third one is going to be the Sims Tailor for the clothes, the medieval style clothes. And guys, I just want to mention that we did not mention the creator of MCC Command Center. I don't know the name because we just cannot more like play Deadpool without it.
Deadpool. Yeah. I wasn't thinking like mod level. I was thinking more like when we traditionally
CC
say
CC level. I see it.
Because I was going to ask like what mod you can't play without. And of course, not including MCC Command Center, because that's everybody.
Yeah. That but isn't that crazy? Life. You need a mod to play the game.
No, UI what's cheats. Even crazier I cannot play without UI is cheats. That they have to shut down their, UI cheats too. Yep. They had to shut down their, what was it? Their Discord, because people were being ridiculous with the MFIT update. Did anybody see that?
No.
I did.
Yeah, it was, I don't engage in Sims Twitter, but I saw it. Maybe. Yeah, the MCC Command Center had to shut down their Discord server because people were being so awful to the mods. And they were like, we do this for free in our free time because we enjoy this and we would like to help the creator. So we're shutting down the server until everything is updated and we feel comfortable reopening it. And it was heartbreaking to watch.
Yeah, and they update immediately. Like,
yeah, and they were just asking for time to like be able to update and fix everything and work out the bugs. And they were telling people a lot of the issues you're having is because you won't troubleshoot your own game and you have multiple mods.
Mm-hmm.
They're like, it's not even also, MCC Command Center.
It's EA's, well, sorry, but if it's anyone's fault that you can't play the game that you paid for, is the people you paid for. So it's EA, not the modder that works for free to help you have a better experience. They shouldn't even be in the equation without getting paid, you know?
Mods should enhance the game, not fix it. Like, I can't play without Carl's Dine Out mod because that mod literally saves Dine Out. Like, it's so frustrating that this is the state of The Sims right now. And I'm glad that they're doing like fixes and stuff. And I'm glad they're being a little bit more open, but they need to be more open. And we keep going on this topic of like Sims team do better. It's not even The Sims team. It's like EA. Like the gurus work hard and they love this game. And there's just certain aspects that things need to change.
What is that? Can I say daddy EA?
What?
No, I was going to say, doesn't Stassi always say Daddy EA needs to get it together?
Daddy EA needs to get it together.
Yeah,
literally. I've stood on this hill many times. The community makes the game. EA does not make the game. Literally, people will be like, you can't say that, you're affiliated. I'm like, Daddy EA will never pay my bill, because that means I'd actually have to be like, oh my God, guys, kits are amazing. They're so great. They just add so much to your game.
And it is so funny watching EA creators. Like, I was watching James Turner, and it's watching him being like, it doesn't really work, and it's kind of weird, but I'm just gonna move on, like trying not to say anything bad about it, because yeah, they're affiliate. That's why one of my favorites is Pumbella, because like she roasts them, and they can't really like, they don't really like unaffiliate with her, because that would be bad for them.
Oh. Yeah,
Sims team,
that would be Sims a bad look. Outrage. So like she openly roasts them, and when she got her kit, everybody's like, you're a hypocrite. I'm like, but she's still like, excuse my language, but she still treats the fuck out of them. Like, I don't understand what you're mad about. She didn't stop calling them out. She just created something she enjoyed and she would actually pay for.
Yeah.
I just want to backtrack 1 second to say that one thing that really upsets me about EA and their bugs is that when you go and report a problem, they're like, first question, oh, are you playing with mods? I'm like, the mods are fixing your game. What is broken with you, tell me, you know? It's like, it's never my mods. It's never my mods, okay? Like, and if a mod is updated,
it's fixed immediately.
Yeah, I don't need to go to them if it's a mod, because I can immediately find that it's a mod and update it or remove it or whatever. It's like, glitches in the game, but they're always in every server. Oh, are you using any mods? Remove your mods. Restart your game. Delete everything from your game and restart it. I don't want to delete my... Sorry, I'm upset.
We're all really passionate about this, I'm noticing.
Yeah, yes. Like, Prom won't work for me in the high school pack. The others do, but Prom just does not work. Oh, my game will just glitch out, then I'd have to exit the game, and I just can't go to Prom.
They don't do anything they're supposed to do in Prom in my game. They just wander around arguing with each other. I learned to stop going.
Yeah. I can't even get in.
Oh my God. Oh.
See, and then my game crashes when they try to go home.
Oh,
fun.
Wow. See, this is what annoys me. So like last night I posted a photo on my Instagram of like, you can now put the soap on the corner of the sink. And everyone was like, holy fuck. And I was like, yeah, cool. Can we just have a game that works though? Like,
true.
Like, then there's gonna be plates everywhere. I love the meme where it's like, yeah, they added slots, but now there's plates everywhere. I have to put something there now. That's a problem.
Mm-hmm. And that patch broke the faces, so
yes,
they're adding more problems.
And now my eyes that weren't broke before are broken. So now I have to go through my mods folder and remove all my CC eyes. So that's fun.
They said they're gonna fix it, but you know what my question is? Because I wasn't updating my game because I knew that it's broken, because I saw people being like, the faces are changed, okay? And then my game crashed because I was doing like a picture, so it forced me to update it, okay? Mm-hmm. And my question is, okay, so you released something, you haven't tested it enough, okay? I get it, underfunded, whatever. You did a mistake. People are like, oh my God, it's broken. Take back the update. Don't force the rest of the players to also break their game. Like, you knew for 2 days before I updated my game that your game is broken now. Why did my game also like require me to update it? Why can't you take the update back or stop it or whatever, you know, instead of releasing a fix? Take it back, fix it, and send it to us again. I don't know, because you can go to previous, you can revert like a previous thing of the game. Well, not now that they have it online, but you know, it's like, it's technologically possible. So you can be like, we couldn't take the release back, you know?
You guys remember the state of the game when the wedding pack came out? Oh, I was so mad. I literally only bought that pack for the sari because I really wanted it. But I bought it like at half price because I was like, I am not paying the full bucks for this, my game to break. And I waited till the game was actually running correctly. And now weddings work, but
that's relative.
The wedding
can go to Tartosa. Can you have a wedding?
No. Yeah. I remember when it started working, I immediately started making a list of like, okay, so-and-so and so-and-so, get married, go, 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 go. I mean, I was just pushing them through arches and weddings, and I'm like, just go before it quits again. Yeah. Oh, you know, it's horrible, and I thought, why am I thinking about this? I shelled out money for that pack. You know, why am I doing this? So,
and weddings are such a big feature for us Sims. Like, we have big weddings and we want to celebrate, and it's supposed to be a happy time, not us screaming at the computer for not letting us sit down
and then crying when it crashes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
If you see a wedding in my game, it is most likely poses. It is not the game.
I don't know how many times this game has made me cry.
I had another question. If you know, how many gigs is your mod folder?
Ooh, well, I'll tell you.
I know.
Mine's, Stassi?
Mine's 30 gig.
Jeez. I knew, and now I have to check because now I can't remember.
Mine is 70.2.
Oh my goodness.
Mine used to be 65, but I did do a CC clean.
Yeah.
Oh shoot.
No, I'm about to download more.
This includes like all my mods and stuff. It's 32.79 gigabytes or 7,869 items.
Mm-hmm.
Nice. My computer ready. Right, let me ready? Check.
Are you ready?
97.1. Hey! Have a beautiful computer.
Yeah, my computer can only do 250. She's
mine's is 82.6.
You know what? I love
mine are around 85 too.
Yeah, nice. You need to tell me where you get all of your CC because I only have 26 point something.
Oh, everyone, we'll send you. We'll send you links.
Yeah, thank you, please. Please send me everything. Send me everything.
I'm just going to post a screenshot of my Patreon list.
Yeah.
Exactly.
You know, that's why I love the Sims community, because, you know, we have Mother Royal Sims, we have Sims Danessa with the collabs. You guys enable me to do worse than I'm doing, and I love it. Thank you. Because I was like, I have so much, but I'm like, Mother of a Royal Sims has more gigabytes than me, so I can download 20, 30 more, you know?
And Sims Danessa, so when I was doing your build, I'm like, okay, how much can she take versus how, you know, I'm like, oh, I don't want to send all that over, you know, and when it's uploaded all to of Google it to Drive, me. I'm like, please be smaller. Okay. I think it's okay.
No, I always feel so bad sending my Sims because I still haven't figured out how to unmerge. I've watched videos. I can never do it properly. Don't know why. I'm so sorry if I send you a Sim with a merge file. I'm not trying to. I'm still trying to figure it out. Also, for whatever reason, my Sims always show up half naked, no hair. I've updated the Sim Tray Importer, and I don't know what's causing that. But like when I send Sims, they're always missing something. Sorry about that too. My bad. But Wes Royal said that they have 9 gigabytes only. They're in the group chat. There's dogs barking. And I'm like, you only have 9? I've seen your game. I don't understand how you manage that.
Yeah.
Oh, you're muted.
I probably have more, but I take some of the folders when I'm playing normally. And then I put the folder back. Like, now it's 9, but it's probably going to be more.
Clever.
Very clever.
Go ahead. When I'm working on my save file on stream, I take all of my mods and CC out. My game loads so quickly, and I'm just like, it pains me because I'm like, I know how fast the game can load, but I refuse to play without my CC and mods.
If you uncheck the show at startup, it's so much faster.
You know
how you get a list of all your mods and CC when you load into your game? If you uncheck the show at startup, your game loads so much faster, trust me.
I will do that. Thank you so much.
No problem.
Love you, girly.
I remember way back in the question. Oh, go ahead.
How many saves does everybody have?
On the computer, or because I have externals. EA has burnt me so many times that I have about 3 years of save files on externals. So I don't know. I mean, I have my main save, I have my screenshot save, and then I have my build save that I just play around in, just playing with builds and stuff.
Mm-hmm. I have my main save, my collab save, and my noble save. My nobles are in their own complete separate save.
I have a main save. I have a main save, collab save. I have a save of all the future stuff I've got in. If I wanted to like mess around with future Sims and storylines and stuff, I do it in there. I have a build save, and then I have like a screenshot save, and then I just have like a random save.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I have my House of Ira save, my Ultimate Decade save, the save file I'm working on, my current household, which is currently the Sims in Bloom challenge, which is at generation 8, just so that I can intermingle with just regular gameplay to keep my brain from exploding. Then I have like my screenshot save, which I tend to delete and then make a new one every time I have like a new event or something. And then I have a ton of save files that I just like to play in, like that I download, like the Simsy save, the Plumbella save, the one I really liked was the, I have the blank save file, which I use all the time to like, that's where all my build, my things are. I almost always start in the blank save because it's less overwhelming for me.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Guys, I am also like mother of Royal Sims. I have a ton of backup, but one thing, I don't know if many people do or whatever, but it has saved me time and time again, especially with the new updates. I don't just set from my Royal save, I have 200 saves of it, because it's like, I do save as every time I finish my game. So that, you know, if that one breaks, I can always go to the previous one and I just lose one day. Because sometimes the update will break your game unplayably. So then you have to be able to go back one. You know, that has worked well for me. Sorry. Bless you.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, I always do well save as. I always do save as. And then, like, I have the 15th of the month mark that I just move all those to an external. Oh,
nice.
I have just three saves, like my personal save, the one that I play just to put my mind off things, the Royal save, and the 100 baby challenge save.
Oh,
how's that? It's good, doing great. I just started recently, and I'm currently on the, I'm putting two together, like this one and the occult baby challenge. So I'm just, right now I'm just doing this, and every day when I finish my game, I put the three saves like on an external, so that way I don't lose anything, but I just have three saves.
Organization.
Yeah.
Does anybody have anything else they want to add?
I love all you guys and I love this community. I'm so grateful for this experience, and I'm so grateful that I have gotten to speak with all of you, because honestly, all of you are such inspirations to me. I was starstruck at the beginning because I was so excited, because you're all so lovely, and I wish only the best and wonderful things for you all.
Oh, well, thank you.
I hope you guys' pillows are always cold.
Oh, that's so sweet. And isn't it amazing how, like, you know, most of you, I mean, with some I've talked, some of you I've never like talked, you know, and we're in this call and just feels like we could talk for 5 more hours. You know what I mean? Like, we're just like blah, 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 like old friends.
I don't know about all that. And y'all gonna lose me in like 2 more hours.
Yeah, yeah. But it's, you know what I mean? Off. Like, theoretically, we could.
Yeah. I could talk to Theoni for hours, honestly. I almost cried when I first called her, because I interviewed her for my final project in my queer theater class, which is actually queer representation in The Sims 4 royalty community, which I'm very excited to share with my entire class. So I almost cried, but it was wonderful.
And, hey, I want to say that Stassi did an episode on LGBTQ class creators in the it was so fun. And you know, one, I think it's coming up, I don't think it's out yet, but one of the funniest things for me is I think we were two people that were we had the co-host, and we were two people, and I am pansexual and the other person was asexual, so I'm like, perfect, we're the ends of the spectrum.
Right? Well, I'll have to watch that one.
That was so much fun. So this comes out in August, but that podcast is already out. So please go check that out. That comes out June 22nd for everyone on this call, but it is already out now. So please go check out that one as well. Yeah. Does anybody have anything else before we wrap up this podcast?
I do.
Thank you, Stassi. Yes.
And it's for you, Stassi.
Oh.
Thank you for organizing this.
That's what I was saying.
It's been real fun.
Oh my gosh. Well,
this has been fun. Yes.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Oh my gosh. Thank you guys so much. I was so excited. I was like, I want to host like a Royals storyteller club. I know there's just so many amazing Royal storytellers out there that I wanted you guys to come meet each other in real life and, you know, share tips and tricks. And I think this was a great podcast, and I hope everyone listening, you know, learn some tips and tricks. And as we know about the storyteller community, we continue to inspire one another, and people listening to this call, you may have just inspired them to start their own royal storytelling stories. So I think that is absolutely amazing that I was able to get all of you lovely simmers here today. But if no one has any more questions, I'd like to do a final round of just who you are and where we can find your stories.
Okay. Sorry.
That's okay.
I'm Michaela, aka Michaela's Royal Sims, and I am that on Instagram and Twitch, and I'm hopefully gonna open a YouTube channel soon. That's something I'm thinking about. So
yes, we need more of us. We need more of us.
I need help setting it up, but I'll figure it out.
If you need help, I did do a podcast of Sims YouTubers. And literally we kind of go through step by step and kind of like how to start and best tips and tricks. So that is out as well if you want to go check that out. And for anyone who wants to do Twitch streams, I also just did a podcast where we went step by step on learning how to start Twitch streaming so it's not fucking scary anymore. I asked all the dumb questions that everybody would have, and it's been a success so far of just learning how to stream, because I think that's like the next step as well for a lot of simmers is after they get YouTube, they start to stream. So anyway,
can you leave me to last? I'm just gonna come back in a minute.
Yes, of course.
I'm gonna do something.
Okay, Wes, how about you?
Yeah, as I said, the Wes.Royals is my Instagram. I'm gonna be back for the PLC stream too, but how's it doing?
Awesome. Please go check out Wes. How about Alice?
I am Royals of Simstan Stacey on Instagram and Tumblr. I also stream on Twitch at Alice's Sims, and I also have my Instagram series as a YouTube series now on YouTube as Alice's Sims again. I also build palaces and do speed builds and stuff, so if you like that, yes.
That is awesome. Marco, how about you?
Okay, I'm here. You can find me on Vaischonia on Instagram.
Perfect.
That mostly.
Yes. Awesome. Please go check out Marco's story. Maria, I will not forget you this time.
Thank you. So on Instagram under Scordovia Royal Sims.
Fantastic.
That's, right now it's just what I can do.
Mother of Royal Sims.
I'm Beth, and I'm Mother of Royal Sims, just on Instagram. I've got some other accounts floating out there, but I think it's just like Tumblr and Twitch and stuff just to follow and stuff. But yeah, just Instagram.
I love it. Royal of Hearts, how about you?
Once again, I'm Megan, aka Royals of Hearts. I'm over on Instagram, and my story will be kicking off very soon. I'm also in the middle of creating a wiki page on fandom where you can find out all about my Sims.
Well, I'm very excited to see that. And I have to take a quick minute and thank my two amazing co-hosts, Sims Royalty 22 and The Sims Kingdom. I could not have done this podcast without you. I literally couldn't have, because I would have had no idea what to ask. I'm sure we would have talked about things, and then we would have probably talked about the weather for the remaining 30 minutes of it. So I want to thank you both so much for being here today. Sims Royalty 22, where can we find your work?
Thank you for asking us to come. I am Gabby, aka Sims Royalty 22 on Instagram and Twitch, and I am also thinking about switching to YouTube so I don't have to worry about an upload schedule. So that might happen by the time this is out.
Well, if it does, let me know and I'll add the links below. But last but certainly not least, Miss Sims Kingdom, thank you again for being a co-host today. You did an amazing job. Where can we find your amazing work?
Well, you can find me. I torture myself, so you can find me almost everywhere. You can find me on as Sims Kingdoms on Instagram, Twitch, YouTube, and TikTok. But don't expect too much of YouTube and TikTok. YouTube is basically my reuploads from my stream. And if you follow me on Twitch, you become part of the royal court. So you can also be a lady, lord, or lordship, whatever you want. And I wanted to also say thank you so much, Stassi. And also, if anyone gets inspired or is a Royal Sims Instagram or whatever Sims Instagram, please really feel free to reach out to any of us, I believe, but also me, if you're starting, if you need help, if you just want someone to follow you and be like, your story is great. So, yes.
We definitely do that.
Yes, we do. So follow us, really.
You guys are so, so, so sweet. I want to thank everyone for coming here today. I'm going to do a little quick self-plug, if that's okay with everybody.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you to all my new listeners. You guys are fucking awesome. I get new listeners every day. You guys inspire me to continue to go on and continue making all these amazing podcasts. We are full for season 2, but the list for season 3 is almost full. So if you want to come in, please let me know. You will absolutely have a spot. I want to take a quick minute and shout out OMG Sims, The Reaper 4. This should be done by now. Please go check out that. I play Amy. Please go check out Davenport season 4. I also play Amy in that. I have a story on Instagram called Rose Chronicles. Please go check that out. That is my baby. I love that story so, so much. We should be at some very interesting moments that have just happened. Please go check out the podcast that I did with The Awful Gamer, where we talk about what happened between 130 and 135 is chapters that I've been leading up to for many years of how important backstory. That's out now. So please go check that out. You guys are awesome. Please go check out everybody on this call and their amazing stories and go follow them and go share some love to them. And let's continue to share love to storytellers because you guys are awesome. And then last, certainly not least, if you would like to be part of my Saturday morning interview series called Story Spotlight, please send me an email. The link's going to be below. I do written interviews every Saturday with storytellers. Please go check those out. We have lots of them. I have about 2 years of Saturdays lined up for interviews at this point. So please, please, please go check that out every Saturday morning, 9 a.m. Eastern time. I think that's everything I can self-plug. I think that's good. Oh, go check out the Mishima Awards. They were filmed months ago, but go check those out as well. Go give Yes, She's a Simmer some love as
love
well.
Love her.
So anyways, I want to thank everybody so much for coming here today. It has been an absolute pleasure getting to know more about your stories and inspiring the next generation of Sims tellers on what a royal story is and how to start. So thank you, thank you, thank you so much for coming here today.
Thank you.
You are welcome. Well, Gabby, your wish is true. Coming true, my friend, which will make some offline. But anyways, everyone, it has been an absolute pleasure. Have a great rest of your day, okay?
Thank you. Bye. Thank you.